गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ सोनाली राठौड, वर्किंग इन वल्लभ बुद्धि पॉलिटेक्निक कॉलेज. अवर सब्जेक्ट इज डेटा स्ट्रक्चर एंड टुडेज अवर टॉपिक इज एरे डेटा स्ट्रक्चर. हियर दिस आर द कंटेंट्स. व्हाट इज डेटा स्ट्रक्चर, व्हाट इज एरे, एरे डिक्लेरेशन एंड द ऑल द लिस्ट ऑफ प्रोग्राम विच वी रन इन दिस वीडियो. First of all, what is data structure? It is a collection of data values, the relationship among them and the functions or operation that can be applied to the data. It means, a data structure means, suppose we have maximum data, those data have the relationship or those data, on those data we perform the different types of operation. This operation is called data structure. In this diagram, you can see that data structure have two types. First is primitive or fundamental, and another is non-primitive data structure. In primitive data structure, there is character, integer, float, and double. What is that? That is the data type. In C, we learn that what is the data type and which type of data type. Here is character, integer, float, and double. Character is used for string values. String value means alphabets, just like the words. Suppose we take the word structure. Structure is one kind of word. In that type of word, we use the character data type. Second is integer, where we have numeric value which have nothing the floating values, just like 1.2, 1.3. Then we take the integer value. For that floating point, we take the float value. Okay, and next is the double. In double, when we have the maximum size compared to integer data type, that time we use the double. In double, floating value and normal integer value we can use. Second, you can see that non-primitive data structure. In that, two types. First is linear data structure and second one is non-linear data structure. In linear data structure, there is array, stack, queue and linked list, and in non-linear there is tree and graph. In this our subject data structure, we learn all these things. First of all, today we start from array. So for first, you can think, what is array? Array is a collection of items stored at continuous memory location, and element can be accessed randomly using index of array. In first year, you can learn C and advanced C programming. In that, you run the arrays program. Similarly, that array is used in C++ programming. What is array? You can see that collection of items stored at continuous memory location. In this diagram, you can see there is the boxes. In boxes, there is the values 11, 9, 17, 89. These all are the values. And in downside, that boxes, the number is declared 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 11. These numbers are indexed. Okay, it means the index of that value. And the upside, there is 200, 204, 208. These are the memory location. This is the address of that memory. They are used to store the similar type of element, as in the data type must be same for all elements. They can be used to store the collection of primitive data type. Here we see that what is primitive data type: character, integer, float and double. Where any variable have the one data type integer, and these all have the same data type. Next is, we can use the normal variable when we have a small number of object, but when we want to store large number of instances, it become difficult to manage with normal variables. When we want to add two numbers, or suppose we add 10 numbers, that time we take the different values. Suppose we have two numbers, so we can take three variable. C is equal to A plus B. A and B is the input and C is the output. Suppose we want to add 10 numbers, then we want 11 variables. Okay, so that's why array will be used when we have large number of instances. The idea of array is to represent many instances in one variable. Now, this is the array declaration. How to declare array? In C programming, we also use, but here is the different type. First is array declaration by specifying the size. Integer array, this is the example. Integer is the data type. Array 1 is the name of the array and the size is 10. Declaration by specifying the size means in this kind, we give the size of that array. There is one other example, integer n is equal to 5. We take the size of array in another variable which we take the n. N is equal to 5. And after that, we take another, integer array 1 in bracket 5. Instead of 5, there we must write n, integer array 1 in bracket n. Then, second one is array declaration by initializing the element. Initializing by element. In here, we take the our array variable, integer array 1 in bracket. You can see that in bracket there is no size, is equal to, in curly bracket we write 10, 20, 30 and 40. These all are the value of array. Here is size is not declared, but the compiler take itself the size of array. In third, array declaration by initializing and specifying the size. Integer array in bracket take the value 5 that equal to in curly bracket 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Okay? We can take, we show that upper side two types. In third type, we use that both type. Next, this is the list of array program. This is the set one of our data structure subjects practicals. First is enter 5 element and using array and find the maximum from them. Second one is addition and multiplication of 3 by 3 matrix. Up to practical 1 to 8 is totally array program, and after the 9 to 12 this all the using string program. Okay, so first is enter 5 element using array and find maximum from them. Let's do the program using C++. Let's go.